When I was a teenager, by accident, I was driving by a coffee shop store. So I walk in and they had these beautiful models. So I ended up buying a couple of them. And after that, you start liking them. I learned how to fly them, and then slowly I start building, and I loved it. And now I build all my airplanes. I build them up. Some of them are from scratch.
The appeal in flying model airplanes is being able to control the airplane. And also the big thing with me is having built it. I design them, I build them, I fly them, and it has been a lifetime passion for me. Wow!
When I was a kid, everybody flew model airplanes. If you wanted an airplane, you had to build it. Now you can go and buy an airplane. It's completely built. So some of the skills we had when I was a kid have been lost, the skills of building, of designing, but things are different now. Now you can buy an excellent airplane and you can spend more time flying it. So we have much better flyers today than we did when I was a kid. There's two enhancements to modeling that have been made possible by the computer. The first one is flight simulators. You can actually plug your radio control transmitter into your computer and you can teach yourself or learn to fly using the simulator.
I'll bring it around so you can see what the airplane looks like. Now you want to see a real crash? It's a lot cheaper than cracking up airplanes.
The second thing is what we call first-person view, or FPV. You actually mount a camera inside the vehicle, and you can broadcast that camera signal to the ground and see it through either a monitor or a set of goggles. Now, I do that with my hexacopter in my airplane, and I can actually see what the camera's seeing through the set of goggles. With this, I can fly at distances of about a mile and a half away from where I'm sitting. And it excels at sitting in a spot right in front of something, or where I can sit and turn it around and look, and I can pan the camera up and down. It's just an excellent experience to fly a vehicle in this way. I'm never going to be a real pilot and fly a real airplane. The time for that's come and gone. This is as close as I can get to being a real pilot.
This is my current project right now. And it's, as you can see, a biplane Stearman. It's all balsa and hardwood, like I think it's spruce wood. And it's covered with fabric, just like the full scale. The history of this airplane is a World War II trainer. Pilots, before to jump in the cockpit of a fighter, they have to learn to fly on one of these. On the full-scale airplane, they close this door, this hatch, with a key. They have a lock. So in this case, I'm using a piece of brass tubing. And then over here, you're gonna have a wire. So when you close it, you move this handle the other way, and it pushes the rod, and it'll lock it. I like to make him look real, like the full scale, right? And that's why I do all my panel lines, rivets, and tiny little bitty details that you probably don't even see it, but I know it's there, and I like it. This fuel valve, of course I cannot make it out of metal, so I have to improvise, so it's made out of balsa and aluminum tubing. I had to remove these fuel lines hundreds of times over and over because sometimes you have to bend it more and then a little bit more and then it's too much. So you have to come back and do it all over again until it fits perfect. The flying club that I belong to is Georgia Model Aviators. We're about 280 to 300 members.
We have everything. We have Wi-Fi. We have tables that we can put our airplanes together on that's sheltered.
We have 55 acres and a paved runway and a covered work area. And you need a big area to fly, an area that's safe to fly in, where you're not flying over people, and where there's other modelers who are coming out and sharing the experience with you.
At the flying field, there is people flying airplanes every day, especially weekends.
See, looking at that form of man?
You see all the way from foamies to monocoque, covered airplanes, acrobatic, big and small. You see all kinds, even jets.
Some people do have jets, and we do have them flying at our field. Not a lot of them because they're very expensive. You can wrap up $7,000, $8,000, $10,000 in one of them very, very easy if you go big with them. The airplanes that I fly are El Cheapo, because I got so many of them. This airplane is called the Hyper Bipe. It's a laser cut kit, and I built it about 4 years ago for a magazine review. This is called the Little Bogey. It's sort of a takeoff of the Playboy, a 1940 design. This is a Japanese Zero. It's a 25-inch wingspan. It's made out of molded foam, and it's an excellent flying model. This is called Sinbad the Sailor. It's another old design back from the 1940s. It's electric, and it's a little bit quirky in flight.
This is where the fun begins.
I'm flying the airplane because I did a review on it for Model Aviation, put out by the Academy of Model Aeronautics, of which all of us belong to. But it's a nice magazine, and every once in a while, they'll call me and ask me to review an airplane. I watch how it flies and how responsive it is and how stable it is and all that kind of stuff. Another successful flight. I'm glad to get it back again, one piece.
Finally, today we got a nice weather, so we got going ahead and did the maiden flight. I did some pre-adjustments already back at home. So I think everything will go okay. Let's hope everything goes okay. The risk of damage an airplane or crash an airplane is always gonna be there. Once the airplane is up in the air, anything can happen. It can be engine failure, electronic failure, it can be anything. It can be the wind, it can be you. All right, here we go, guys. Man, I'm shaking. Woo-hoo!
Man, the sound, this sounds so good, huh?
I cannot imagine myself just flying and not building, or just building and not flying. I like to do both. I enjoy spending hours and hours, hundreds of hours building an airplane, and then see it fly. It's just unbelievable.